Now we're going to my birthplace, Clos de Vougeot, Monopole. This is one of the most famous wine of the Côte de Nuit. Remember, the Côte de Nuit is a very small area, only 9 kilometers, normally welcoming all the top guns of red, 28 out of 29 Grand Cru. There's only one Grand Cru red that is not in the Côte de Nuit. This is Corton, and we recently presented that fantastic wine, the Corton Charlemagne, or Le Charlemagne in the white category. The equivalent of this wine, I think, in the Côte de Nuit is the Clos de Vougeot Blanc. It was originally planted by the monks in 1110. Can you imagine, after 60 years of observation and having planted the Clos de Vougeot Rouge, the Pinot Noir, they said on this beautiful magnetic triangle, we should indeed have a white wine. It's amazing moments of observation, from the birds to the earth, lifestyle that happened in it, to the soil, that they said that should become our alto wine and that should be a white. It's amazing that over 950 years it has remained as such, and is one of the most sought after white from the Côte de Nuit. In fact, one of the only one. You may venture to say there's a little bit of Musigny, there's a little bit of Nuit Saint-Georges Blanc, but very small quantities. This is literally 10,000 bottles produced as one of the wine that adorn a lot of the key cellars around the world, all the fine dinings, but of course as well, all the great pinnacle places like the Vatican. I'm ecstatic about this wine because I was born across this vineyard. We were able to purchase it in 1997. We horse plow it. We obviously cultivate it all as Chardonnay. There's 1 or 2% that is a surprising grape, maybe a little historical Pinot Blanc. However, this wine is aged uniquely into the barrels that come from the Cîteaux forest. The same monks that actually built the Clos de Vougeot, planted this vineyard, had all those great forests. Those oak trees are cut, and after 350 years of age, and we then make barrels from it. So it's a full circle that really respect this diamond among the rubies. Clos de Vougeot is a must. It's become, again, one of the most allocated wine of the entire collection. Therefore, you need to have it.